Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Ray and it is Learning Korean with Ray, day 203. Thanks a lot for tuning in. And yeah, today we will go into the grammar of lesson 21. Yesterday I finished up the vocabulary and today we will do a little review in the beginning to really make sure that vocabulary of lesson 21 is in my head. And I can remember that in my memory, I should say. Yeah, because it was, or it were 39 words and I learned them in 2 days. So we'll see, we'll see. But I have a good feeling. And yeah, after that review, we just jump into the grammar and learn how to ask questions. So let's start by going into memorize here. Well, that is not memorized. yeah. That is memorized. Okay, so we have 29 words ready to be reviewed here. So let's go. Okay, meter.
Meter.
Kasu.
Kasu.
That's an older one. Centimeter.
Centimeter.
Moderate. Jok. Jokdanghada.
Jokdanghada.
Nice. Hu. Nugu.
Nugu.
Mionmyot.
Mionmyot.
To be to not be enough to be lacking. Pujokada. Pujokada.
Pujokada.
Again, still practicing my writing, typing. To experience. Okay. Oh, that was a hard one. I know to explain, but experience. No, I don't know this. But this is not from yesterday. This is not from lesson 21.
경험하다.
경험. 경험. Okay.
경험하다.
Dawn. Wow. But I know it, I think. It was either Sebyok or She or Shinbyok. One of those. I'll go with Shinbyok first. Okay, then it's Shibyok? Sebyok?
Sebyok.
Okay, it was Sebyok. Okay. Middle school. Chunghakyo.
중학교.
중학교. Desk. 책상.
책상.
Ah, yeah, this is one is from yesterday. So not the one with B. Okay, not the one with B. That was Polso, I think Polso. Ah, wait, not the one with B. Um, I think that was Imi. Imi.
Imi.
Nice. There when it's close. Okay. I always get this one wrong in the first try, but then it's right in the second try. So there's Yogi, which is here. There's Corgi and Chorgi, right? Here, they are close, they're far away. Yogi, Corgi, Chorgi. So this one is the close one, there but close, is Corgi.
Corgi.
Nice. Okay, see you later. Okay, that was the first phrase I learned on howtostudykorean.com yesterday. See you later. Najunge do payo. Najunge do boa. Wow. Yo. Why yo? Wait, where's the mistake? Yeah, it was here. Jung.
나중에 또 봐요.
나중에 또 봐요. 나중에 또 봐요. 봐요. And we have a spam in the chat again. Ben. Oh man. Always these spammers.
Appa.
Yokshi.
Yokshi.
Hi Kaya. Welcome and thanks for tuning in. Sosol.
Sosol.
To be simple. Gandanhada.
Gandanhada.
Gandanhada. To lose. Jida.
Jida.
Gradually. Jom jom.
Jom jom.
To ride. Tada.
Tada.
To experience. Gyeonghomhada.
Gyeonghomhada.
Where. Odi.
Odi.
When. Onje.
Onje.
Why, where?
Where?
Man. Especially. Took. Tuki.
Tuki.
Okay, so I had that earlier, but there are two words. I had the wrong one earlier, but this one, now it's correct. So, that was... Pol? Polso, yeah.
벌써.
Yeah, that was the one that I entered earlier as well. Okay, nice. Pleasant Jin. Jin Gapta. Jin? Jill. Chilgabda. Chilgabda. What am I missing? Chilgopta. Is it Chilgopta?
Chilgopta.
Nice. To regret. That was the one with a lot of H. Hu hua hui hu hui hada.
Hu hui hada.
Hu hui hada.
Hu hui hada.
Okay. Nice. Okay, 10 more. Nap. Nat jam.
Nat jam.
Nat jam. To bless chukbuk hada.
Chukbuk hada.
To check out of hospital. Toy. Toy. Toy yok. Ne, toy gwon hada.
Puwanada.
Tuewanada.
Tuewanada.
Cho. Chorophada.
Chorophada.
Shin.
Shin.
Upyo.
Upyo.
Manhwa. Ah, comic book. Manhwa check.
Manhwa check.
Mom. Omma.
Omma.
Bill. Chongguso.
Chongguso.
Wedding. Kyor. Kyoron. Shik.
Kyoron shik.
Okay, nice. Annyeonghaseyo, Flo. Okay. Yeah, so lesson 21 is complete. I think I don't need to review all the words again, because most of them were just in the review that I just did, so yeah, should be good. Review two words, okay. To win. Igida.
Igida.
News. Soshik.
Soshik.
Income. That's more than two. Sweep.
Sweep.
Okay, I think now we actually reviewed all of the words from that lesson. So now we are ready to go into the grammar here. That is not the grammar. It's so weird. I see what the problem is. Wow. Firefox got updated. My browser got updated, and the name of the window changed. So my streaming software finds the correct windows. For example, for howtostudykorean.com, I have another window for Memrise, and it finds the windows automatically by the title. So I've set up the title, but the title is different now after this update, because the normal title of the website is always the same. It depends on the website, obviously, but then there's like a dash and then Firefox, Mozilla Firefox. And they changed this dash, they made the dash longer. So it's another character, and my streaming software doesn't recognize it anymore. So I have to change that. But it's basically changed now. Not a big deal, but funny little, weird little change. Okay, now let's go into lesson 21. Okay, asking questions in Korean. Okay, asking questions in Korean at the first glance is very easy. Nice. But first glance. For the most part, asking questions in Korean without the use of a question word is incredibly simple. Yeah, you just go up with the voice and add a question mark at the end. Asking questions in English is unnecessarily complicated. If I ask you the question, do you like sports, in English, what is the meaning of the word do? In that sentence. In English, whenever we ask a question without a question word, we need to include words, the words did, do, will, to make the listener know that we are asking a question. Yeah, but in Korean, we just put a question mark in the end, I think. This is not an English learning website. We learn Korean, okay. We don't. Questions that do not use a question word don't need to do anything structurally to make the sentence a question. All you need to do is raise the intonation at the end of the sentence to make it sound like a question. Yes, I know that. Nice. Or I kind of assumed that. I think I recognized that from my limited experience of Korean YouTube videos. It's basically the same sentence. My mom ate. 엄마는 먹었어요?
엄마는 먹었어요? 엄마는 먹었어요?
엄마는 먹었어요? It sounds like there's a stressing on that syllable. 먹었어요?
엄마는 먹었어요?
That's weird, right? I expected more like 엄마는 먹었어요? 먹었어요? And not 먹었어요. It sounds a little bit weird. Okay. Remember that Korean people rarely say the word you. So if you ask a question to a person, you're talking about the person you are talking to. You can just... Wait, what? I have to reread that. Remember that Korean people rarely use the word you. So if you ask a question to the person you're talking to, about the person you're talking to, you can just omit the subject from the sentence, of the sentence. 밥을 먹어요? 먹었어? 밥을 먹었어?
밥을 먹었어? 밥을 먹었어? Chipe casso.
Sushi gil derosso.
Sushi gil derosso.
It's funny. It doesn't sound like similar to how I say it. It's definitely different. So when I say it, my voice goes up in the end, and that's how questions usually work in European languages, right? But here it sounds like the I don't know the English terminology here, but the tone doesn't go up, It just gets louder, but the tone actually goes down still.
소식을 들었어?
들었어. So it's not 들었어, or it's not like that. 들었어. It's 들었어. So.
소식을 들었어?
들었어. It's not 들었어. It's weird to me. So it just sounds like it's a bit louder. The end syllable, like there's more louder stressing on it, but it doesn't go up like it usually does in other questions. Oh, by the way, we have 5 viewers right now. Is that correct? Welcome to all the viewers. Thanks for joining. If you have any questions, just go ahead and put them in the chat. If you're talking to somebody and the subject of the sentence is not the person you're talking to, you can just use the subject as normal. Also notice that regardless of the tense of the sentence, past, present or future, you don't need to do anything special other than raise the intonation at the end of the sentence.
남동생은 울었어요?
There's again the stressing on this second last syllable. We can't ask question yet, yeah. So, for any new person watching this, it is allowed to talk in English in the chat here and ask English questions. Or you can also use German if you want, and I translate for you to English. Yeah, again, the stressing here is clearly on the second last syllable.
남동생은 울었어요?
들었어요? 들었어요? Maybe because the 요 is actually just like this high respect conjugation. But this is the real end of the sentence, regardless of the respect conjugation, you know? German Spain 6-0-06. Are you talking about soccer or football? Okay, I'm not following football at all. I don't care at all. But yeah, I guess it's a very uncommon result, yeah. So are you Spanish? Are you Spain? Are you Spanish? Then good for you, I guess, if you care about football. So let me try this. Okay, so here there's no yo in the end or so. So this is here, there should be the stress. How do you say that? I guess the stressing on the real last syllable here.
한국은 좋은 나라야?
나라야?
한국은 좋은 나라야?
나라야?
한국은 좋은 나라야?
I don't know. It just sounds weird to me. It really doesn't feel like the intonation of the questions in European languages. It's so weird.
엄마도 올 거야? 엄마도 올 거야?
Again, it sounds like the stress is on the second last syllable. 거야? 거야? 엄마도 올 거야?
엄마도 올 거야?
Interesting. So I guess I don't know. I just need to hear more questions. But it just sounds super weird for me so far. Okay, so you don't need to change anything structurally, but you can. So let's see. 심니가. The formal high respect 심니다 is never used as a question. When asking a question in this form, instead of using 심리다, you must use 심리가. I guess, since this is like a double G, that means there's, you pronounce it like there's a G in the end of this syllable already, so maybe it's 심리가, 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 심리가. Let me see. 심리가.
방학 동안 집에 안 갔습니까?
Yeah, sounds good. Okay, when asking questions in this form, yeah, okay, I already read that, so this is added to the stem. Okay, we know that from 심리다, it's just ga in the end. You can do that with all tenses. 방학 방학 동안 집에 안 갔습니까?
방학 동안 집에 안 갔습니까?
Okay, do you want to meet that person? 그 사람을 만나고 Okay, again. 그 사람을 만나고 싶습니까?
그 사람을 만나고 싶습니까?
Are you going to school tomorrow? 내일 학교에 갈 겁니까?
내일 학교에 갈 겁니까?
I've never seen this, specifically this syllable in this context. This is interesting. I've just never seen this form. So, 심리다, or 엠니다, added to the future form, because this letter is a noun. It's a ko. It's like a short form for thing, ko. And it's very weird to me that this conjugation that is usually added to verb stems gets added to a noun here. I mean, it's not like technically a noun, I guess. It's just a part of the future form, but it's still a noun. So that looks weird. Usually you only see koyeyo. Interesting. Okay. Are you going to school tomorrow? Wait, that's the same sentence. Ah, okay. So here we have the normal form, not the short form of the noun that has an S in the end, and then it's 임니다. 임니까 in this case. 임니까. Oh, we have a picture here. Interesting. So again, 내일 학교에 갈 것입니까?
내일 학교에 갈 것입니까?
Okay. I work at the school in Seoul. So, Seoul. In the bathrooms, there are charts on the walls that the cleaning staff is supposed to check once per day. it really tells you a lot that he's saying is supposed to check and not is checking every day, once a day. Written on these charts is a list of questions about the state of the bathroom. While you will not understand most of the words on this list, notice that all the sentences except the last one have the ending 심니까. 합니까? 합니까? 씁니까? And so on. Okay. Some of the words provided in these in the 10 sentences above are fairly difficult. However, I would like to translate for you. Yeah, I'm not sure if we need that, if I should learn all these words now. I mean, mirror we have already. Let's find mirror here. Coal, yeah, coal here in the beginning of sentence 3. What else can I see very quickly? Probably not much. Huajiangshil, restroom. Oh, okay. So I guess Huajiangshil Yong is right, Yong. Yongyi is paper. Yongyi is paper. Huajiangshil is restroom. So this is restroom paper, which is toilet paper. Very good, very good. Yeah, okay. I don't think I need to go over this. We'll just continue. There are other ways you can change a sentence to make it a question. 씁니까 is typically the most formal. We'll talk about the others in the upcoming sections. Okay. Korean questions. 니. When asking a question, instead of ending your sentences with a or o, you can end them with 니. Okay. This is an informal way to ask your questions, and you can do this in all tenses. For example, 했니? 먹었니? 갔니? 이었니? Okay, so far I don't remember hearing that before. 하니? 먹니? 가니? 이니? Don't think I've ever heard that before. Okay, however, note that this form gives the sentence a slightly feminine feel to it. Okay. I've never once used ni. Okay. However, I work at the Korean high school and hear female Korean teachers use this form all the time when asking questions to a student. XY? Can you elaborate on that, M. Zoro? What is XY? Siomil jal patni.
Siomil jal patni?
Oh, panni, okay. Sorry, try to start another app on my phone. Well, okay. Okay, so I guess a double S in the end, followed by an N, gets transformed to an N. That's really interesting. Let me check that out in the rules chart. Pronunciation rules chart. So we have a double S, bottom letter, double S, and then next letter is an N, which is here. So double S and N makes N plus N. Okay, so yeah, that makes sense. So now it all makes sense that I've never heard the things that I read here. So hetni or mogotni, because that cannot exist. So it's mogoni, henni, kanni, ioni. And that sounds a lot more Yeah, I don't know. The chances are a lot higher that I've heard that before. I will use this form since I'm a female. Man, we have so many different forms already in Korean, like depending on the person you're talking to, the tenses, the honorifics. We have so many particles, like we have so many different things already, and now we even have different ways to say the same thing depending on the gender. Wow. So I guess I should just skip this part because I'm not female. But I will read this just to get some reading practice in. So I read the first one already. I guess I didn't do it correctly. 시험을 잘 봤니?
시험을 잘 봤니?
서울에 가겠니?
서울에 가겠니?
가겠니? 몇 반이니?
몇 반이니?
몇 반이니?
몇 반이니?
Okay, 이미 졸, wait, 졸업, 졸업하다, 졸업했니? 이미 졸업했니?
이미 졸업했니?
Okay. Yeah, nice. Get ready for much more, eh? Yeah, I know. In lesson 7, you learned how irregular words change as a result of adding different additions. This is the first time you have been introduced to adding ni. And I don't need it. And the only irregular that applies when adding ni is the r irregular. When you add ni to a stem of the word that ends in r, you must drop the r from the stem and attach the grammatical principle to the remainder of the words. For example, 열다 plus ni, 연이. Okay. As you know, some additions require the speaker to choose between two possible options. For example, choosing between a and o when adding a and o. Or o. What? What's that sentence? The speaker must choose between two possible options. For example, choosing between a and o when adding a or o. That just sounds super weird. Choosing between a and o when adding a or o. I'm not seeing the point of the sentence. Notice when adding ni, there's no choice. I call it a solid N. That is, there's only one choice. It starts with... Okay. Okay. There's only... There are not two forms that you add, it's just ni. But this sentence is still very weirdly written. Okay, in later lessons you will learn other grammatical additions that have a solid end. For example, na. Oh, is that the male form of ni? Nin. Ninde. Oh, ninde. I heard ninde so often already. Ninde. I heard that so often. I immediately recognize this from all the videos. Ninde. Ninde. Yeah, that's... Wow, I heard this so often. I have to check it out what it is. I can't jump to this chapter. I click it and nothing happens. Usually when I click it, like the title of a chapter here, I jump to it. But for this one, I don't jump. The most common meaning of ninde. When placed between suppliers, even though. This sounds oddly familiar. I feel like I already read this. It seems since you're negating the fact that you don't. Did I already read this? It's a complete deja vu right now. I'm sure I've read this part already. Maybe I don't know, I guess I must have googled it in the past and just forgot about it. And probably stumbled across this chapter here. Interesting. Or maybe this part was copied on some other website. And I read that, and I didn't come to this website here. Interesting. Yeah, okay. I don't want to read the whole sentence here, the whole chapter now. Okay. So, back to Ni, solid N. That is super useful. Okay. Haninde. What? I don't get it. Haninde. All grammatical addition where solid N is attached to a word follow the same rule as when ni is added. Below are some examples of ni in use with the r irregular. What are you making? Bois mandini. Mandini. Bois mandini.
뭐 만드니?
뭐 만드니?
뭐 만드니?
Ninde has so much meanings. You can just use it, and the chances are high it fits. Okay. You keep hearing it often if you watch Korean TV. Haninde. Yeah, I probably heard that. I definitely heard ninde, and the chance is high that it's Haninde as well, maybe, yeah. I definitely heard this so often. Yeah. Anyways, we continue here. Yeah, we continue. Korean questions. N or... So enga, nga, ngayo, or ngayo. Just like ni, you can also end your questions with n or nga. Adding yo to the end makes it more formal. Okay, this form is less formal than the high respect simnida. Yeah, simnika. I use it mostly when I want to explain a situation or use it as but. Okay. But, I mean, lesson 76 is very far away. I hope I get some more information on that here on howtostudykorean.com before lesson 76. Okay, anyways. This gets added to the stem of adjectives. Okay, only adjectives. Using this form makes the questions a little bit softer than using the forms described previously. The forms, I mean, one of the form is apparently only for females, and the other form is just, yeah, it's just basically one other form. Where are we? Here. The sex exact difference cannot be translated perfectly, but sort of like how would it be okay if I go to the park? Sounds slightly softer than can I go to the park? Oh, question mark is missing. Okay, you add an or in to the adjective stems like you would when conjugating it to describe a noun. Okay. Jebda, jebbin, jebbin. Jagda, jagun. And then attach ka or kayo. Ga, yeah, no, it's ka or kayo, but in reality, if you really use it, it's always ga. But when I read this sentence, I still have to say ka, even if I know it's always ga in a sentence. Okay. Then attach kayo after that construction. Yepin gayo. Jakun gayo. Gayo. It is only conjugated to the present tense and therefore usually only used to talk about some sort of present situation. For example, is that girl pretty? Okay, only present tense, okay. Is that girl pretty? Okay, so only a present and only adjectives. Adjectives. Yeah, that's always pretty much the current situation. Is that girl pretty? Ke yojanin yopinga 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 ke yojanin yopinga
ke yojanin yepunga
yopinga
ke yojanin yepunga.
Is this too small? I cosin nomu. I cosin nomu. Jakin gayo. Jakin gayo. Jakin gayo. I cosin nomu. Jakin gayo.
이것은 너무 작은가요?
가요? 작은가요? 작은가요?
이것은 너무 작은가요?
가요. Again, the stressing is on the second last syllable. It's not 작은가요? 작은가요? That's not it. She's saying 작은가요? 가요? 가요? Or gayo. So this really the focus is on this second last syllable all the time.
이것은 너무 작은가요?
Gayo. Not gayo. It's so weird. Because in German and English you always put the rise of the tone on the very last sound. And here it's definitely not the case. Okay, is that school good? Kö hakyoga. Choin. Choinga. Choinga. So, I would say 그 학교가 좋은가? 좋은가? But I predict it will be 그 학교가 좋은가?
그 학교가 좋은가?
Wow, okay. 좋은가? So weird. I will need a lot of time to get used to that. I mean, I can st still obviously hear that there's a clear difference to a normal sentence, so I can easily recognize that it's a question. Even if this particle would not be at the end, but it's still weird. It still needs time until I can remember to use it in the same way. Okay, is this work task too complicated? 일이 너무 복잡한 복잡. Have I learned that? 복잡하다. Can't remember. 복잡한가요? 복잡한가요? 복잡한가요?
일이 너무 복잡한가요?
가요? Okay. It's commonly added to Ida as well. Is that person a teacher? 그 사람이 선생님 선생님인가? 선생님인가? 선생님인가?
그 사람이 선생님인가?
님인가? 그 사람이 우리 엄마인가?
그 사람이 우리 엄마인가?
That's a weird question to ask. Yeah, maybe if you look at older pictures or so. Yeah, I guess. Okay, Aninga. Aningayo is very commonly used at the end of a full sentence to say no. Ah, Ani. Aninga. Aningayo. Aningayo. When you're asking yourself a question that and if you're doubting yourself, okay. The good old isn't it?그 여자는 한국에서 가장 예쁜 여자야 아닌가?
그 여자는 한국에서 가장 예쁜 여자야, 아닌가?
아닌가? It's not 아닌가? It's 아닌가? 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 아닌가?
그 여자는 한국에서 가장 예쁜 여자야, 아닌가?
아닌가?
그 여자는 한국에서 가장 예쁜 여자야, 아닌가?
Ah, but here it's better. Here it's not as extreme. Okay, let's listen to this.
너무 복잡해, 아닌가?
That was good.
너무 복잡해, 아닌가?
This feels like a different person. I feel like that was a different voice to all the other audio samples.
너무 복잡해, 아닌가?
Okay. So I focus a lot of the pronunciation and about reading. I have to also recap what I actually just learned from this chapter. So we learned simnika. We can add simnika in formal situations to do to ask a question. And we can also use ni for females. I will ignore that. Nin or in ga for present tense adjectives, so asking about the situation, current situation. Nin ga. And that is very common with aninga. Okay. Korean questions. Nayo. Na. Using na at the end of a sentence to ask a question has the same function of ninga. Okay. That is, it can be used to make the question sound slightly softer. Wait, we already had the softer before. So this one was already softer, right? So this one was already a bit softer. And now this one is the same, but even softer? Or what? Or is it comparing with completely other? Not with the one that we learned here, but completely other. So it's also another option to make it softer. Not more softer than the previous one. Often used with verbs. Okay, so inga is for adjectives and present tense. Na is for verbs. And ita or opta. Opta. I don't know. Opta, I think. Needs to apply it again. Okay. Because we add the solid N. One option. No two options and an N. Okay. Pabi itna. Oh, wait. Again, pronunciation rule. The double S becomes an N. So, pabi inna.
Pabi inna?
Sagwado yogi so panayo.
Sagwado yogi so panayo?
Yogi so here. Okay. Sagwado yogi so panayo? Palda to sell. Irregular panayo. Okay. Is the Girls' Generation concert here? Oh, Girls' Generation. See? I'm not a fan of K-pop, okay? So, I know nothing about K-pop except all the things that I see in Korean YouTube videos. And it's often there. Like, the K-pop always appears in any Korean YouTube videos. Like, every now and then there's K-pop stuff in there. Doesn't matter what kind of topic you watch. So, I know, like, a little bit. So, I know BTS is, like, one of the biggest bands. And I also know some other ones, like... Actually, do I? If I see a list with names, I can definitely tell which one of those are K-pop groups, but I can't really think of the names. Like, was there like For You? No, I don't know. I know BTS. Okay, I know BTS. BTS. But so that was a prelude to the thing I want to say. So that's my situation about K-pop, okay? But Girls' Generation, Girls' Generation is a whole different level, okay? Girls' Generation is actually the first K-pop group that I have known. Because, you know by now that I'm pretty deep in the StarCraft scene. And there was a StarCraft tournament probably like 12 years ago or so. And in the live stream of that StarCraft tournament, I think it was in between the games, they actually always played that song of Girls' Generation. And it became such a big running gag, such a big meme in the StarCraft scene. It was everywhere. Like this song by that band was everywhere in the StarCraft scene. So I completely know this. I know this group, and I also know that song. This GGG. I don't know it anymore, but back then I could just sing the whole song. That's like, I don't know anything about League of Legends, but I know Faker, Kana, Teddy, Effort. I know Faker, that's it. I have no idea about League of Legends. I did play some Dota, so I know the Dota teams and pros, but that's it. To be honest, I'm also not a big fan of K-pop, but sometimes it's okay. Yeah. It's just funny that when you're going around Korean learning communities, 95 of them want to learn Korean because of K-pop, I feel. It's incredible. It's always K-pop. Like, you can't find a single Korean learning Discord server without K-pop. It's not possible. K-pop is everywhere in those communities. It's crazy. Okay. Anyways, we got a little sidetracked here. Let's finish up this chapter. K-drama is also a big topic. But K-drama, I want to watch K-dramas, but I don't want to watch them for the plot or for the story or for the content of the movie. I want to watch them to increase my Korean learning, you know? But I think I'm not quite at the level yet that I understand enough that is really useful. But I will in the future. When I know a bit more Korean, I will definitely start watching K-dramas and try to understand as much as I can. I listened to it to get used to hearing Korean, but now I like it. Songs are addictive. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much the characteristic of music, right? I think that's the same with every, like almost every song that exists, or every popular song maybe. Doesn't really matter what genre or what language or whatever, or if you usually listen to that kind of music or not. If you listen to a certain song over and over and over again, you will start to like it at some point. It's unavoidable. I guess it's helpful even if you can't understand it. Yeah, maybe. But I want to increase the helpfulness a bit more before I start it, you know? I don't want to waste good K-dramas for a little bit of helpful. I want to use those K-dramas for like good effectivity, you know? I hope you get what I mean. I don't want to spend a lot of time for a little gain, little reward, little benefit, if I can get more benefit from those same movies later on. Okay, so we continue here. So again, nayo for verbs here. And we have to remember the pronunciation rule, inna. And we have to apply irregulars. Okay. And this form can also be used in the past tense, unlike the previous form for adjectives. That can pretty much only be used in present tense. Okay. Did you have your bus card? Transportation card. Kyotong is traffic. Kyotong car. Karte. Okay. Card. So traffic card. Kyotong karte. Kyotong karte ga isonnayo. 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 Kyotong karte ga isonnayo?
교통카드가 있었나요?
있었나요? The stressing on the na kills me, man. Watch Korean movies last time. Oh, actually, I thought K-dramas are movies already. So I guess if you say that, I assume K-dramas are mostly shows, like multiple episodes or seasons. Weird. Pandora is a really nice movie, but hard to understand because they are screaming a lot. Okay. I really enjoyed my sassy girl. I will come back to this topic later on, and then you can put all your movie and hell, even K-pop song suggestions if you want in the chat, and I will write them down and go through them at some point. Okay, Twitch watch party. Yeah, we can do that as well, but we are not watching full movies here on stream. Also, I'm not sure if it's allowed. If I watch a song, for example, on Twitch here on YouTube, I think it's like, is it allowed to upload that to YouTube again, or is it like I'm copying the song? I guess as long as I'm not trying to earn money from it, I think it's fine. I hope. I don't want to get my YouTube channel striked. But yeah, we will do that. We'll do that. I will figure that out. Yeah, see, I'm always learning. It's always the same pattern here, with vocabulary, the grammar, the videos. Oh, by the way, Kaya, I think you were not here yesterday, right? I have sad news about the practice videos, but let me finish my thought first. So it's always the same pattern on the streams, always the same structure here. But at some point, my Korean will be good enough so that we can just watch a wide variety of Korean stuff on YouTube or whatever, and get some more, yeah, just some more different content in here. But I'm still not at a level. Let's not get ahead of ourselves here. And now to the sad news, Kaya. No practice lessons anymore, practice videos. Lesson 20 was actually the last lesson with videos. There are no more videos. Yeah, it's sad. It's very sad. Yeah, I guess they also take some effort to make. But little happier news. Something to make the sadness a bit less strong. I went to the howtostudykorean.com YouTube channel and I found that there are recap videos for every single lesson where he summarizes the important things from each lesson. So the videos are always like 4 or 5 minutes. And, well, maybe even 3 minutes or so, I don't know. And yeah, I think that's a great thing to watch here together. So instead of doing the usual practice videos that are not here anymore for the future lessons, we will do some of the recap videos, like 3 recap videos or so from the previous lessons. And I think those go even higher in the lessons. So there are a lot of recap videos for the future lessons as well. And yes, we do also have the workbook, and we'll do that. I still have the workbook until lesson 25, and I guess if we go to workbooks here, yeah, there are many workbooks. I mean, in the end, he is earning money with the workbooks. And he's not earning money with the YouTube videos. Okay. Yeah, so I will probably also get the next workbooks. There are definitely workbooks available for a lot of the future lessons, so those will not stop at all. Yeah, until 125 there are workbooks. So if we reach the lesson where we don't have a workbook anymore, which is lesson 126, then I don't think I care about that anymore. We'll find other ways to learn and to practice that knowledge. Okay. So with that, I think we'll end today's stream and continue. Let me go back to the lesson here. We didn't learn a single question with a question word. Okay, yeah, we just learned this. So using question words is the next big chapter. So we'll do that tomorrow. We'll learn about all the question words, all the 4 question words that we learned for this lesson, which is why, when, where, and who. Yeah, so that's on the plan for tomorrow. And with that, this stream comes to an end. So thanks a lot for watching and see you next time. Hopefully tomorrow at 6 p.m. So bye bye and annyeong.